talking about being late. It's tough. It's tough because now the way what happens now is that my wife will tell me different times. Like, you know, you budget like a half hour for my time. And Eric Scott brought up the point. He said I'm the only former military guy that he knows that is habitually late. Because most of the, you know, you learn a pretty tight regimen in the military, and it didn't take with me. Just did not take. All right, I am joined by Lieutenant Governor Kim Guadagno. Kim, thank you for joining me again on New Jersey 101.5. Good morning to you.
Good morning, Bill. You know, you were late on Friday, too.
Okay. All right. I was not sure if you were going to call me out on that.
Now, It was too easy.
It was too. And what was funny is that I'm assuming that you are absolutely like on time to the minute, because Suzanne called me at 2:02 and said, okay, where are you? I'm like, oh, boy. So what happened? I missed the turn. I missed the turn, and then I had to turn around. And then for whatever reason, and then Diana was following me. Uh-huh. And then she must have looked like we then pulled over to turn around. And I guess, I don't know, she looked down at her phone maybe for directions or something. And I left. So then I was sitting at the end of the street waiting for her. And she thought that I just took off.
You just need to get to the Jersey Shore more often. That's all.
I think that's exactly it. I think that is exactly it. So real quick, we met on Friday, and we're gonna air that tonight on Chasing, so people will be able to see that our full conversation. But I wanted to talk about this socks thing that you're doing, because you challenged me to go buy socks.
Did you?
Not yet. I will. Oh. All right. I will. I promise. I will be up to the challenge. Here's what happened. I did all my shopping online.
Oh, no excuse.
I know.
No excuse.
Go
to the grocery store and buy some socks.
I'm going to do it today. I'm going to have the socks today. Is it okay if I delegate that? Because my wife is out Christmas shopping today. Can I delegate it? Can I just text her?
No. And then have your wife mad at me? No. I went in, bought my own socks. You go in, buy your own socks.
All right. I will buy the socks. Tell me what the socks are for, and tell me a little bit about the charity. I will do it myself. I get it.
To back up just a little bit, every year the governor's entire cabinet does what we call a season of service, and we try to give back to people. And every year we do something. Like, you saw a list today of all the different things all the cabinet members are doing. But what we are doing in the Secretary of State and Lieutenant Governor's office is we're doing something called Rock Your Socks. And we're challenging three high schools, Ocean Township, Ridgewood, and Cherry Hill, to collect socks so we can turn it over to kids that are living at Covenant House. These are teenagers that don't have a roof over their heads. And we called Covenant House and said, how can we help? They said, you know, these kids get everything at Christmas time but socks. So Suzanne, my marketing person, came up with this idea. Let's do a Rock Your Socks campaign. So I challenged you to produce some socks, and you agreed to the challenge. And I know you don't usually do that.
No, because that was the thing, Kim. I explained this to you on Friday that I get really agitated, because I think so many people go after these. Let's raise awareness and let's feel good about doing something. And they dump a bucket of water on their head. And in reality, that's not helping anybody.
No water on anybody's head. This is socks that we'll be collecting and going directly to the Covenant House. Yeah. We go to each of these high schools and play a videotape from these kids that have been homeless and living in cars and living in basements, living in alleyways, who found their way to the Covenant House. And during the Christmas season, we wanted to do something like you, something substantive.
Yeah.
And this is what we've come up with. So I'm glad you took the challenge, and I'll be waiting for those socks.
All right, so I can't could I challenge my wife and then she could buy them while she's out? Does it work that way? No, it's not going to go buy the socks.
Turn to Eric Scott right now and challenge Eric.
All right, you know what? I'm going to do that, because Eric just left the newsroom. All right, so Brian, when he comes back, we're going to put this challenge to Eric Scott. And because I think I agreed to buy 20 pairs.
You did. I didn't ask you for 20.
No, I know. All of a sudden, I raised the ante on myself. I don't know. I tend to do things like that. I got to stop talking. That's the problem. I get myself in more trouble. But it does go to a really good cause. And the socks that you buy are going to end up on some kid's feet. Like, it's going to be that direct and immediate.
Right. We're picking them up and handing them right over to the Covenant House. They have joined us in this campaign, and it's really a nice thing to do for the season of service for the governor's office.
Yeah, I think it's great, and it's direct and it's impactful. So all right, go ahead.
If anybody wants to know more about it, they can check out my Facebook page or send me a tweet.
Oh, you know what I'll do? Will you, if you tweet, you're up, because I have to tell you, you are incredibly active on social media. So very impressed with your Twitter acumen. You're always on. Yeah,
it's great. For a 56-year-old, it's this new skill set.
Yeah, well, you're pretty good at it. And so let me ask you this. If you could tweet out the link to your Facebook page. Maybe I'm right. Can you, if you can do that? I know that's like the graduate level Twitter use, Kim. So I'm not trying to call you out. Suzanne can help though. But if you can tweet out that link, then we'll retweet it and get people talking about it, because I think you're right. In the spirit of giving and service during the Christmas season, it's important. And for me, I don't do a lot of stuff like that when it comes to awareness, but I love to be able to be helpful directly to people. And this is that kind of thing.
And you are. Thanks.
All right. All right, everybody. Kim Guadagno, Lieutenant Governor of the great state of New Jersey. I really appreciate you joining me on New Jersey 101.5. You will have your socks within the next 72 hours, I promise.
Oh, I will call in if I don't get it, or I'll tweet if I don't get it.
I know you will.
Keep up this conversation from this morning. I really like to listen to it. It's very important that we start talking about what's going on in Trenton and people are aware of it.
You know, I will. And thanks for saying that, because it is incredibly important. And I think we need to start hearing solutions to the problem. So definitely over the course of the next few weeks, you and I will be talking more and start getting into some concrete solutions on how we fix it. I did say that now it's a team of three. It's me, you, and Joe Piscopo have decided to dig in.
I moved here 25 years ago to marry my husband, who was born and raised here, and I had all my kids here. There's no way I'm going anywhere. I keep telling that to my husband. And I want to add one more thing. You know, the governor's office, the new people in the governor's office are already in a defined contribution plan, and the world has not come to an end. I don't get a pension. We're in a defined contribution plan already.
See that?
So
that,
it works.
It works. It works. And it will, there will be something there for you at the end. So that is great insight that now needs to be applied, I think, throughout state government. So that's something that we'll continue to talk about and work on. Lieutenant Governor Kim Guadagno, thank you for joining me on New Jersey 101.5. Merry Christmas.
Thank you too, Bill.
All right. Take care, Kim. Thanks. Bye.